What's up, Internet? I need a new headset. Ito, natatanggal na yung adhesive, natatanggal na yung foam cup, yung leatherette nagpipeel off na, yung rubber lining dito sa wiring na nagchichip na din, nagka-crack. The headband is, di ko alam ano nangyari dito, but it's pretty bad. Ay! Buti na lang, pinahiram ni ASUS yung isang headset nila, yung H3. And hindi naman to sponsored review, pinahiram lang nila, but these are my honest thoughts. And it's actually a very solid headset. Unang-una, solid yung build quality niya. Stainless steel yung frame with a leatherette headband. Very solid pa rin yung feel niya, pero magaan siya. There are notches in the band so that yung mga medyo OC, talagang masasakto mo yung position na gusto mo. At matatandaan mo, like, oh, this is the, you know, I like notch 3. Or, you know, whatever your setting na gusto mo para madaling tandaan later on kung may ibang gumamit. Madali lang bumalik dun sa setting mo. The Tough logo is etched on the sides with mukhang brushed aluminum tong parang side portion ng headset. And it's a subtle look. Hindi naman sobrang heavy ng branding. But it's a nice touch and it looks good, na nice understated. The initial end of the wiring is rubber, so it's black coated rubber. It does come with a splitter, so yung splitter niya, yun yung maganda na mesh yung cord. And then the splitter ends with the microphone jack and audio jack. If you won't be using the splitter, you can plug it basically into any device that has the standard 3.5 millimeter jack. There's a volume dial on the left side and a mute button also on the left side. So very easy to use, straightforward, and very easy to find. Wala masyadong bells and whistles to kasi ito yung medyo mid-range or yung medyo... Actually, mid-range yung price para sa Philippine market, pero para kay ASUS feeling ko ano lang to eh, parang entry level lang nila to. They have much more expensive headsets. The cans are comfortable when you can use the headset for extended period, wala namang problema. Yun, hindi naman siya mabigat, so pwede mo gamitin for long periods. And after a while, you basically forget you're wearing them. There's a slight pressure when you wear them, but it's a good kind of pressure na alam mo na hindi mauhulog kahit medyo mag-tilt ka side to side, mag-lean back ka, or things like that. Yung ibang headsets kasi na subukan ko, medyo kinakabahan ka, hindi ganun ka ganda yung grip dun sa ulo ko. Parang pag konting lingon lang, baka tumalsik. But itong H3, it does a good job of staying on your head without being cumbersome or noticeable or annoying. And of course, most importantly, sobrang okay nung sound quality niya. Even compared to the other headsets I've used, I can hear more nuances dun sa sounds na naririnig ko. Hindi lang sa games, but also sa mga videos, mga TV shows na pinapanood ko. Actually, that's a nice thing about when you use headsets. There's a lot of audio detail that you miss if you're just using speakers. Sometimes sa mga TV shows, they like overlaying several musical themes to underscore what's going on in the plot. And usually they're very subtle, you can't really hear them, but when you use a headset, especially a quality headset like this one, yun, mas nararamdaman mo talaga, mas naririnig mo. And that also includes the gaming experience. You can hear the yung usual sa FPS na yung footsteps or sounds of gunfire, yung mga audio cues like that to help you out in the game. And this also does come with virtual 7.1 surround. So I was really actually impressed with the sound quality. The quality of the mic is also good. Your voice sounds clear. Maririnig ka naman kung sino ka chat mo sa Discord or kung sinong, let's say, ginagamit mo pang live streaming or things like that.
Baka the bios. Playthrough PH on YouTube asks, nagsi-COD ba kayo? And Rafael and Art, kento ko kay Jobert off-camera na whenever we post about ESGS, whenever we talk about it, everybody's like, you know.
At nagamit ko nga siya dun sa ibang videos ko and rinig mo naman na okay naman yung sound quality. Kung hindi maganda yung audio, hindi na yung kasalanan ng microphone, kasalanan na yun nung natural microphone ko. Meaning, boses ko, wala na, yun na yun. That's my voice is annoying, the microphone can't compensate for that, sorry. Pero yung gustong-gusto ko talaga dito sa H3 is that quality headset siya, good build, good sound quality, good mic quality, pero mura siya for what you get. Mga 2,300 yung street price, pero I've seen it go for lower online. Yun nga, mid-range price yun for the Philippine market. There are cheaper headsets like 800, 900. But for the quality, what you get here, sobrang bang for your buck na tong H3 na to. Just to compare, yung medyo ka-level niya dun sa Cooler Master, yung MH630, and ito, mga 2.8 dito sa amin sa Hardware Sugar. Sa iba, mas mahal pa. And yung ka-level niya sa Corsair is tong HS50 Pro, and ito naman, mga 3,300 sa iba. Sa amin, it's around also, I think it's also around 2.8 or so. So medyo kapareho niya yung H3. So they're on the same level because they all basically have the same features, they all feature the same quality. Pero yun nga, kung pipili ka dun sa tatlo, the H3 has equal quality if not better at a much lower price point. So yun talaga yung selling point nitong headset na to. Sobrang bang for your buck, good value for money. At to be honest, nagulat nga ako nung nakita ko yung street price kasi yung mga competitors niya are around 30% or so more expensive. Pero si H3, mga 2.2 lang. And so definitely, it's good value. And if you're just looking for a mid-range headset, there are many other headsets with a lot of bells and whistles, wireless, RGB, better surround sound. But again, for price point performance, it's really hard to beat the H3. And thanks for watching.